Hey guys, welcome back to Andy's Dinosaur Reviews, and today we have ourselves another of these brand new Godzilla X Kong, the new Empire figures to check out, and this time we have Shimo with the Frostbite Blast. Now this figure is one that took me a little bit to find. I definitely had my troubles getting a hold of it, but luckily my local Walmarts have now begun putting out all of the Godzilla stuff, so I was able to find pretty much everything that I was interested in acquiring to my collection, or at least for the most part. And again, I'm not entirely sure how you say this kaiju's name. It looks like it would be Shimo, but I've also heard people pronouncing it Shimu, so I'm not too sure. If you guys happen to know the absolute correct pronunciation of that, definitely let me know. But you can see the figure looks quite interesting overall. Pretty cool for sure. And then here on the back, you can see an image again of the figure, as well as a checklist down here of all of the other figures that are in this wave of the Godzilla X Kong, the new Empire figures. So let's pop this out of the box and check it out. So here is our Shimo figure, and let's get the feet in a better position. And then of course we also have the I guess Shimo's version of the Atomic Breath, which apparently is called the Frostbite Blast. But the figure does look pretty cool. You know, it's definitely a very unique looking kaiju. And although I'm sure there is a fair amount of people that are like me, and, you know, we were hoping for some other, you know, Toho monster, some other Toho kaiju that we've seen in the past to appear in the new film, rather than a brand new invention, a brand new creation. You know, I really would have preferred a classic Toho kaiju to get the legendary treatment, but it is what it is. The figure does look pretty fun though, so let's jump to a closer look and check it out from there. So starting up here at the head sculpt of our figure, you can see it has some fairly decent looking detail. It also has a very interesting look. Now we haven't actually seen Shimo yet in any of the trailers, or at least, you know, there's some parts of the trailers where you feel like you may have seen like a glimpse of Shimo, but we haven't seen a full reveal quite yet, so I don't know how perfect the likeness of the figure is, but it definitely has a very cool appearance to it. You can see kind of like some scutes running from the snout there along the top of the head, leading back here to the back where we are filled with very interesting crystal-like spines for our Shimo. And of course, down here on the side, you could see some decent looking skin texture and stuff, some decent looking scale detail. I feel like the overall fine detail here in the face of the figure is actually quite decent considering what we've, you know, been given with a lot of these Playmates figures. I feel like it looks a little better. And you can see the nostrils right there. The eye is basically just a blue spot. That's it. There's not really anything else going on in there. And in that little eye area, there's not really a whole lot going on detail-wise either. We do have an articulated jaw, which can actually open all the way down. Like, that goes pretty wide, which I don't think is the best visual for it. But the inside of the mouth is about as generic as it could possibly get for a giant monster figure. You can see we only have a tongue kind of sculpted out in there, and it's painted with a pink, and that's it. No real coloration going on the inside of the mouth. Up here on the upper side, there's obviously a slot there for the Frostbite Blast to go into. We do have teeth sculpted out, which they look okay. They're painted with kind of a, like a yellowish tone. They're not too sloppy. I mean, they're not great, but they actually look a little better, I think, on this side. Not terrible, not perfect either. Actually, the teeth in the lower jaw over here don't even look like they have paint on them. So again, a little iffy as far as those teeth go, but the articulated jaw does work pretty nice. As you move down along the course of the neck, you have like some scutes moving down here along the side of the neck, kind of like some rigid looking skin texture here for the underside. And then you also have some ridges following along the spinal column up there. And obviously these crystal like spines here coming off of the back of the head have a very cool translucent purple to them, which is really quite neat. We do have neck articulation, so the neck can go down and up. That's about as high up as it goes. It's about as far down as it goes. It can also swivel, so it does give you some pretty decent poseability for the figure, which is definitely nice. I actually quite like that aspect. And then as we continue to move along, as we reach the body, I feel like the skin texture becomes quite muted compared to what we see up here in the head and neck area.
And that is something that is unfortunately fairly common for these Playmates Godzilla X Kong figures. And the detail doesn't look terrible. Like, as you move down to the lower part of the stomach, I feel like it looks fairly decent, especially here on the underside where you have a very interesting kind of like a scoot-like scaling moving down through the chest and stomach region. But up here, specifically where you would expect to see like the shoulder blade and stuff, you could see it's very muted, very smoothed out. Up here on the top, we continue to have those very cool translucent purplish kind of, again, crystal-like spines moving along the back of our Shimo all the way down. We also have a pretty decent leg sculpt here, or arm sculpt, I guess you could call it, potentially. And this one seems to maybe be a little bit of a, definitely a little bit of a different material than we have for the body, because the detail, I think, shines a little nicer out here as you move down the course of the front leg. Definitely some decent-looking fine detail. You've got all sorts of scoots moving down, and then you've also got a pretty nice looking foot sculpt down here, but the nails unfortunately don't have any paint for them. But again, that may be what it looks like in the film. I don't really know since I haven't seen it yet. As far as the articulation goes, you can go forward and back. And I think, yeah, you could swivel all the way around. You can also come out away from the body, and we have a swivel in the wrist, so, and that can of course swivel all the way around. So articulation-wise, it's actually really quite nice, as they usually are for these smaller 6-inch figures. They usually have pretty decent articulation. As you move back here into the legs, you can see, or the, you know, rear legs, you can see, again, pretty much the same style of sculpt as what we had seen on the front leg with the scoots and stuff, moving down along the side, moving down along the front, right over the knee, down the shin, and then you move down into the foot sculpt, and the foot sculpt also looks fairly similar to what we see on the front leg, maybe a little bit longer would be the toes. And we also have leg articulation back here. You can go forward and back. Definitely can't swivel all the way around. Maybe, but you'd really have to try. The legs unfortunately don't come out away from the body back here, but you do have ankle swivels yet again, like we saw for the wrist. And then you move out here toward the tail, and you do have those very interesting scoots, again moving along the side and underside of the tail of our Shimo. And then up here on the back, you see more of those ridges leading out here along the course of the tail, and they do continue to have that purplish tone kind of airbrushed over. And then we lead out, and we have a very interesting looking tail for our Shimo, again kind of almost similar to the new Godzilla, the new evolved Godzilla as well. But you can obviously see we've got some very nice purplish tones out there for the tail. And then the underside also sports those purplish tones on the underside of that area, but just the white here for the rest of the tail. And no articulation past this point. Obviously, we have the ability to articulate this tail all over the place right here, and of course swivel as well. But once you lead out here, the tail is sculpted in this position. There's no more articulation. It's not like a wire tail, so it's always in that curved sort of position for it. The other side's going to pretty much see the same thing for the figure. I really don't see us having too much difference on one side compared to the other. Of course, the legs are slightly different when it comes to the positioning, but overall it looks pretty much the same, again, from one side to the other side. They're really loving this thin waist for the kaijus in the newer film, and I can honestly see quite a bit of similarities between this and Godzilla, so I wonder if, you know, maybe they're related somehow. I don't know if that's the case, but very interesting figure for sure. And then, of course, we have Shimo's Frostbite Blast, or Atomic Blast, or whatever you want to call it. It has a very cool sculpt, very nice translucent blue to it, which looks really cool, and I'm quite intrigued to see this in the film. Again, it's not too far off. We've only got a few short months until this actually releases, so I'm pretty hyped to see this movie, but the Frostbite Blast also looks really cool, and the translucency to it has a very, very neat look to it overall. And then to apply the Frostbite Blast to our Shimo, obviously you can see there's like a little peg coming out here, so I'd imagine we're just going to kind of shove that up there into that hole and then close the mouth or open the mouth, whatever you want to do. But you can obviously see we've got that blasting out of there. And yes, I do know that in my 6-inch Godzilla review, I put the atomic breath in backwards. Didn't realize it at the time until afterwards, when actually my son pointed it out straight away, because he has to do that sort of thing to me. And then I felt like an idiot, but it is what it is. I've moved on. As far as the size goes for the figure, lengthwise, you are looking at about a little bit under 9.5 inches, or closing in on 24 centimeters. And then for a height, about 4 3/4 inches or around 12 centimeters. For a size comparison, there is Mr. Papo T-Rex, the Attack Pack Colovosaurus, Robert Muldoon, and the Collect A Human Being next to our Shimo figure from Playmates. And you can see it does sport a pretty decent size to it. Not massive by any means, but pretty much the size you would expect when it comes to this particular line of Godzilla X Kong figures. And then for another comparison, we also have the figures from the same size range as Shimo here with our Kong and Scar King. These are 6-inch figures, or at least that's kind of what they're labeled as, even though these are part of the 2-pack. Next to our Shimo, you can see that obviously Shimo is a little bit bigger. Now, I do, of course, have the 6-inch Godzilla here, but I'm not going to compare it with this figure right now because I also have the 2-pack, which features a different version of this figure and the Godzilla. So since I'm going to be reviewing that in the immediate future, I don't really see much of a point in bringing in the 6-inch Godzilla as I will be comparing them anyway. And the final comparison that we'll do this time around is the Battle Roar version of Godzilla next to our Shimo figure here. And you can see that the size honestly isn't that drastic compared to each other. So I am pretty excited to see how the 6-inch Godzilla measures up to this one, because I would think potentially it's similar in size to what we'll see in the movie, but I guess we won't really know again until we see the actual film itself. So this brand new Playmates Godzilla X Kong articulated Shimo figure is pretty darn nice, actually. I will say it's probably one of the better figures from this line. And in fact, I would say, honestly, most of the figures have been okay in this line. Some a little better than okay, like the certain Kongs and Scar Kings, when it comes to like the 6-inch versions, are definitely very nice figures. The Godzillas have been kind of a letdown the entire way through. I don't know why. I just have been just very underwhelmed with the Godzilla figures. But this one's pretty decent. And maybe it's because it's so bright that you can't really see that some of the detail is muted. But overall, I think the sculpt looks fairly decent. It also has some nice looking detail and the translucency to the majority of those crystal-like spines moving along the head and back look really cool. The coloration is definitely unique and stands out, that is for sure. And of course, on top of all of that, you also have a lot of articulation on this one. Not a massive amount, but what we do have is really nice and smooth. Like, the neck articulation is great, if you ask me. The jaw articulation is okay, even if the inside of the mouth is pretty lame. But the, you know, leg articulation and stuff is also quite nicely done, especially in the front legs. The tail is okay, nothing really to brag about there. But overall, I think that is really quite nice and a very interesting design for this new kaiju. And of course, we have its Frostbite Blast, which is really neat. It definitely looks cool, and I actually think it looks way cooler than the Atomic Blast that the Godzilla figures have. So definitely a neat looking figure. Again, if you are interested, head to your local Walmart, because that's where I snagged this one from. And of course, like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next review. Thanks for watching.